Hello. In today's video, we're going to take a look at this 1960s, I believe, General Electric transistor radio that I got at a local thrift store a while back and haven't done anything with. As you can see, I paid $7 for it. This is one of the ones that's covered in a rawhide leather covering with a leather handle. I think this one is AM only. I've got a volume over here and the tuning capacitors over here. It's made from, as you can see, genuine top grain leather. Has some snaps that allow us access to the inside. And let's take the inside out and get a better look at that. Okay, in order to get inside this thing, you need a nut driver. There's a couple of nut driver screws. There's two on the back, and then there's two on the sides that are hidden normally by the knobs. Once you take the knobs off, you can see those. So you remove all four of those, and then you can pull the whole thing apart. All right, here we are with the chassis out of its rawhide container, and we can get a little better look at the radio itself and all the components. Everything's laid out up here on the top. Here's our speaker, of course. We've got some information as far as the model and stuff here on the back. And it looks like it's model P-720, super heterodyne. Gives your tuning range, your battery supply, which should be 6 volts, 4 standard D flashlight batteries is what it calls for. And of course, for best performance, always use General Electric batteries and components. So this is one of those rare instances where the manufacturer is actually the name on the logo as well. Let's see. It looks like there's a date code there, GG50, and I'm not sure. I think the GG gives you a year with GE components, but I'm not 100% certain. There's some other codes over there on the speaker. Again, not really anything I'm familiar with.
As you can see here, we have some capacitors that we probably will want to replace on this thing. This capacitor is old. That one, these are all original. This one probably needs to go. I'm sure these are almost always leaky, this type. These electrolytics will need to go for sure. It looks like we have another one over here. So let's replace those. Let's see what's going on with that. That looks like that's cockeyed or loose, maybe even. So we'll look at that too. Make sure the traces on that aren't broken or anything. It looks like some kind of chassis number up in there too. What does that say? Retma 720C. That might be some kind of number for the board anyway. But yeah, that's the first things first. What we really need to do here is definitely change these capacitors. So before we do anything else, we'll probably put some power to it, see what it's doing now, and then we'll change these capacitors for sure, and then and do an alignment if need be, and just see if we can get this thing, how good we can get this thing sounding. Okay, we have this thing out on the kitchen counter here, and we have a power supply set up, and we can hear a pretty terrible hum coming out of it. But here's our power supply that we're using. We're just plugged into a universal supply, and got some gator clips going to the battery terminals. We've got a pretty bad hum, which is probably a filter cap issue. We need to replace those for sure. I'm probably doing alignment because I'm getting one or two little stations, but very faintly. See, there's something there. Just being overwhelmed by the filter cap hum. So let's Let's go ahead and change the caps in this thing and see where that gets us. Okay, I think we got this thing pretty much ready to go and aligned. The severe noise that I was experiencing before was a result of being plugged into the wall with just the DC battery power. We're not having those severe noise issues, so that had to do with the wall, which makes sense since it's an AM radio. But we did go ahead and replace those electrolytic caps, so this should be good for a long, long time. Replace this one over here as well. But gave it a bit of an adjustment on the alignment. Getting a lot of stations now. Well, I say that, but I think this camera is actually messing with it now. The closer I get, the more the camera messes with it. So yeah, you know, at least everything works now and it does bring in some stations. Let's get it back in its case. Okay, here we are in the daytime. This radio is all put back together. We're going to see what kind of stations we can get. I'm going to use my cell phone to film this clip rather than this Canon camera that I sometimes use. This thing seemed to be introducing a lot of interference, which is odd for a camera. I guess it's maybe the recording is creating some kind of electromagnetic field. I don't know. But anyway, it is definitely interfering with the recording. So let's try it with a cell phone.
Talks about is a process of belief. And that is really with belief. and he has wired you to be able to breathe. In fact, have you ever noticed that your tear ducts, you know, kind of operate right below your eyes? I only cry during sappy commercials. Well, that's my point. Knowledge. Would I lose my wife? I'll ask her. I haven't asked her that. I've asked her everything. So I'm going to do. I'll lie under her in a moment.
If you're wondering what that weird noise is in the background, that's my daughter chewing on one of those rubberized flooring mats, you know, that they're like ABCs and shit, that you puzzle pieces you put together. That's her chewing on one of those across the room. Some of these stations aren't going to come in no matter what you do, but... So yeah, there's the full AM band, so... And there's this little GE... Probably, I'm guessing actually this is probably from the 50s now that I think about it. Not the 60s. But yeah, so there we go. If I ever want to get my conservative talk radio fix or my Bible study on, now I have an AM radio with which to do that. So yeah, if you guys haven't already done so, hit the subscribe button below. You know I jump around a lot on these videos. I have a lot of varied interests. I know I'm doing stuff like, you know, radios and hi-fi sets when the name of my channel is The Guitologist. However, you know, sometimes it's cool to mix things up. I like to fix those ride-on toys with my daughter as well, so, and dig things out of the garbage and film that. And we're going to also talk about some of the crap that I get at various flea markets and Goodwills and things probably going forward. So, yeah, we'll mix it up a little bit on the channel, keep things fresh, and there, as my daughter cries us out, I will bid you all farewell, and y'all take care.